As we've been saying, in times like these, an education is one of the best ways to face the future. And here's a way to help with a high SAT score that can score you a free college education. Listen in.
You might call Josh Burke the original college prep genius.
I always think I do, like, really horrible on tests and then end up doing pretty okay.
Okay. 1600 was a perfect SAT score when Josh took the test. His score? 1540.
Pretty much every single day for about a year, our mailbox was stuffed this full of college offers. This was everything from full ride, full tuition, free room and board, graduate money.
But while Josh earned his stellar score, Mom Jean deserves the extra credit.
Well, good.
When it was all said and done, we threw away 7 trash bags full of college offers.
The former homeschooling mom is the author of College Prep Genius, the SAT prep course she developed while helping Josh and sister Judah prepare for the College Board test. After both kids earned free rides to college, including study abroad, other families asked Jean for help.
I would put my screen over there and then sit the kids in the couches and in the table and at the bar, and that's about, I could max out at 20, but after a while, there's no way I could have done that.
Today, Jean teaches her College Prep Genius course in half a dozen Texas public school systems and dozens of private schools all across the country. Jean says the key to her whole system is logic.
But once you can understand the logic behind the questions, how to approach it with a critical eye, you'll start finding those recurring patterns that the College Board uses, and you'll stop falling for them.
First place to boost your score, the critical reading section, where you'll find 4 passages, 24 questions, and you'll have 25 minutes in which to do it.
The College Board only puts the answers in key places.
Here's how to approach the dual passage section.
The way they designed it is not the way you answer it. They do this because they know that most students are going to read passage 1, read passage 2, and then start answering the questions. Mm-hmm. And they've mixed the questions all up.
So read one passage at a time. Find and answer the related questions, then move on to the second passage. For vocabulary questions, insert each answer into the question. The one that fits grammatically is the right answer. And in the overall passage section, Jean says the College Board usually puts the answers in the first and last lines. Moving on to math.
Especially for girls, this tends to be an intimidating section.
Well, here's the neat thing about the SAT math. You don't have to be a math genius to ace the test.
Jean says, sure, you need to know basic math, but remember, this is a logic test.
The more calculations that you tend to use, the bigger chance of mistakes. So you want to cut your calculations down and find the shortcuts.
And finally,
the essay.
Oh,
the dreaded essay.
Worth 1/3 of your grade, you're given a topic and 25 minutes to make it great.
The key is on the essay is that it doesn't matter what you know about the subject at all. You can just make it up. All they want to know is, can you take a topic and give us 3 examples to back it up what you believe? They only spend a couple minutes on your paper. So if they can read your paper and know that it sounds good and sounds like it fits the topic, then that's what's going to get you the high scores.
So follow Jean's pointers and make sure you practice, and you too could be a college prep genius.
It can be figured out. You don't have to be a genius to ace the SAT.
Best part, Jean's 10-hour workshop classes cost $99. Most of them cost thousands. For 21 specific ways to improve your SAT scores, go to our website in the education section for her top 21 test-taking tips.
No way am I telling you my scores. We'll be right back, everybody.